Hello learners, good day to all. I am Dr. Vishal Sood, teacher educator. Today we are going to discuss about one of the most important aspect of teaching learning process, that is continuous and comprehensive evaluation. Without this process, teaching learning process can never be termed as completed in itself. So we will today discuss about different aspects of continuous and comprehensive evaluation and how this process is carried on in the classroom, in the schools. So the learners, the main points of today's discussion will be the holistic personality development, the evaluation for holistic development, meaning of evaluation and its importance, continuity in evaluation, the comprehensiveness in evaluation, evaluation of scholastic aspects, and the evaluation of co-scholastic aspects. So our today's discussion will orient around these major aspects, these major points which are related to continuous and comprehensive evaluation in teaching learning process. Now, as you know that the educational process or teaching learning process is carried for the personality development, and personality development has three major dimensions. Three major dimensions of the personality are the cognitive aspect of the personality, affective aspect of the personality, and the third one is psychomotor aspect of the personality. So we provide education to the students, or the teaching learning process is carried for the development of these three aspects of personality: the cognitive aspect, the affective aspect, and the psychomotor, or which is related to the skill part of our personality. Now, holistic development of our personality can be seen in four major dimensions. First is related to intellectual development, which is related to the mental abilities, the development of mental abilities among students. These mental abilities include reasoning. These mental abilities include creative thinking. These mental abilities include critical thinking. So these are the part of intellectual development, one of the dimension of holistic personality development. The other is physical development. Then the third dimension of our personality is emotions, that we wish to develop the emotions, we wish to develop the emotional part of the personality of an individual. And fourth aspect of individual's personality is related to the social and moral development. That means through education, through teaching learning process, we wish to develop social and moral values among the students. So these are the parts, these are the aspects, these are the dimensions of our personality, and we provide education to the children for developing these four aspects of our personality. Now, if personality development is there, then definitely a question is there that there must be certain procedures for evaluating the holistic development of personality of any child. So how to carry out this evaluation? But before that, one question is, why evaluation? Then what processes constitute evaluation? Then the next question arises, when to evaluate? Next question, whether it should be a single shot event, the evaluation should be single shot event carried at one time only, or it should be continual or a periodic process carried on regularly. So these are the questions which we have to answer before implementation of any educational process or before assessing the personality of any child. Apart from this, there are certain other questions which arise, that what to evaluate, whether to evaluate all the dimensions of the personality of the individual, and then the question arises, how to evaluate, whether there is only single tool, single technique to evaluate, or there are a number of tools, there are multi tools, there are multi techniques to evaluate the different aspects or different dimensions of the personality of an individual. So in order to answer these queries, first question, why evaluation? Why the need of evaluation is there? The first is to ascertain child's development in various dimensions at different stages. At different stages of development throughout his life, if we wish to ascertain the child's development in different dimensions, there is need of evaluation. Then the other need for evaluation is to certify the learners, to certify the students in terms of what has been achieved by that student and what is still missing, what he has not learned so far. So for this, evaluation is required. Then the third reason for conducting evaluation is to identify the learning difficulties of the child, whether the child has learned all the concepts that has been taught by the teacher in the class or not. If there are certain learning difficulties, if there are certain hard spots, then those learning difficulties are to be identified through the process of evaluation. And then the next need for evaluation is, the next task of evaluation is that on the basis of evaluation, we try to provide remediation. Remediation means corrective measures. We try to apply the corrective measures on the basis of the identification of the learning difficulties of the students. Then to ascertain the effectiveness of three M's, matter, methods and materials. That means whether the content matter taken for the teaching learning process was effective, and if it was effective, to what extent it was effective. To ascertain this thing, we need evaluation. What methods have been adopted by the teacher in order to ascertain the effectiveness of those teaching learning methods, those pedagogical techniques, we have to do evaluation. Then, in order to ascertain the effectiveness of the materials, the teaching learning equipments or the teaching learning materials used by the teacher during the teaching learning process, in order to ascertain the effectiveness of those materials, those equipments, we need evaluation. Then, the next reason for conducting evaluation is to grade a child as pass or fail, or to promote him to the next class. So this all is done on the basis of evaluation. And the last and foremost and important reason is to make evaluation as assessment of learning, assessment for learning, assessment as learning, and assessment in learning. So assessment or evaluation should be, there should be assessment of learning, assessment for learning, for improving learning, assessment itself is in learning, and assessment in learning. So these are the aspects. For these reasons, we conduct evaluation in the classroom processes. We conduct evaluation in our education so that the different dimensions of personality development could be assessed appropriately in an effective manner. So this was the need to conduct evaluation. Now, what elements constitute evaluation? Evaluation consisted of two major aspects, two major elements. One is measurement and the other is assessment. That means measurement and assessment both constitute evaluation, plus value judgments. Value judgment regarding the child is also a part of evaluation. That means evaluation is very broader in nature, is having a largest scope, and measurement is a part of evaluation. Assessment is a part of evaluation, plus value judgments. The value judgment means the judgment about the value of the child, or when we give remark to the child, then that also become a part of evaluation. So evaluation is both measurement as well as assessment plus value judgment about the child. Then when to evaluate? The next important question is when to evaluate the child's progress. Then the question is, it should be at continual intervals, it should be at periodic intervals, and it should be a regular process. The evaluation of the child should be a regular process, and it should not be a single shot event. It should not be conducted at only one time. Second thing about evaluation, that it should be comprehensive in nature. Comprehensive means it should cover all the aspects of the personality. It should cover all the dimensions of personality. That means evaluation should be multidimensional in nature, which in which all the dimensions of the personality should be evaluated, and that evaluation is known as comprehensive in itself. Now, when we talk of continuous evaluation, that it should be conducted at regular intervals, it should not be a single shot event, then when we talk of this continuous evaluation, what do we mean by continuous evaluation? This is the question. What do we mean by continuous evaluation? Continuous evaluation means that there is frequent conduct of unit testing. We try to conduct tests of the students, we try to evaluate the students at regular intervals, at frequent intervals. Then there is regularity of assessment. That means assessment is conducted on regular intervals. Then there is use of corrective measures. That means use of corrective measures means if a child is not able to learn something, child has certain hard spots, learning difficulties, then through this continuous evaluation, we try to provide him corrective measures. We try to provide him feedback. Then there is provision of retesting. When the corrective measures are applied, when the feedback is given to the student about his or her difficulties, particular learning difficulties, then again those students are tested in order to assess whether the students have learned those things or not, or whether those learning difficulties still exist or not, or have got removed. So in order to do that, we again conduct the process of testing. So this process is known as retesting, and it is also a part of continuous evaluation. Then if certain particular specific learning difficulties remain there, then we try to diagnose those learning gaps. We try to identify those learning gaps, and it is also a part of continuous evaluation. So you can see on the screen that different features of continuous evaluation are there, that the tests, unit tests are conducted at regular intervals, the assessment is carried out frequently, there is periodic assessment, then there is provision of corrective measures and provision of feedback to the students regarding their learning difficulties. Then the provision of retesting is there, where the students are again tested to know whether the learning difficulties have got removed or not. And then if the particular hard spots are there, then on the basis of evaluation, we also diagnose those learning gaps. So these are the characteristics of continuous evaluation. I hope you have understood about these features of continuous evaluation. Now, continuous evaluation. Continuous evaluation includes formative evaluation and second, summative evaluation. Formative evaluation means what? Formative evaluation means the evaluation testing of the students carried out at short intervals on a regular basis, that is known as formative evaluation. Formative evaluation, this word has been taken from the word formation. That now what? Formation of what? That means formation of the content matter, the formation of the knowledge during the teaching learning process. And when the formation of that knowledge is going on in the classroom during teaching learning process, and then during that formation process, we try to evaluate the students at regular intervals, either through verbal means, verbal questioning, or through written questioning, then that sort of evaluation is known as formative evaluation. Now, why we conduct such type of formative evaluation? This formative evaluation is done to identify the learning progress, to check the learning progress of the students, and to identify the difficulties, if any, remains there. So, formative evaluation is for improving the learning among the students. Then, another part of continuous evaluation is summative evaluation. Summative evaluation, as the word itself says, summative means sum total. When the sum total of the learning experiences have been given to the students, then at the end of the semester, at the end of the session, at the end of a particular course, when we evaluate the students, then that sort of evaluation is known as summative evaluation. Summative evaluation includes all the content matter, all the syllabi of a particular course. It is generally conducted at the end of the session, and the main purpose of summative evaluation is to grade or to certify the learner as pass or fail, or to promote the student from one class to the other class. So there are differences between these two parts, that is formative evaluation and summative evaluation. Formative evaluation is for improving learning, for identifying learning difficulties, to provide feedback to the students, whereas summative evaluation is done to grade the student as pass or fail, or to certify that learner, or to promote that learner from first class to the other class. So, but both of these, formative as well as summative evaluation, these are the part of continuous evaluation. So this, in CCE, the continuous aspect of evaluation indicates two: one, the formative evaluation, or the summative, and the second, summative evaluation. Now, the comprehensive evaluation. Comprehensive, as we already said, that comprehensive evaluation means the evaluation of all the aspects of our personality. That means cognitive aspect, affective aspect, as well as psychomotor aspect. So, when all the aspects of child's personality are evaluated through different means, then we say that such sort of evaluation is known as comprehensive in nature. Comprehensive, which covers all the aspects, different aspects of child's personality. And in school situations, these aspects can be classified into two parts. One are the scholastic aspects of child personality, the other are co-scholastic aspects of the child personality. Now, what these scholastic and co-scholastic aspects of child personality indicates or refer to? Now, as you know that we have different abilities. Any child, any individual have different abilities, and these abilities can be classified into six parts as given by the Bloom's taxonomy of cognitive domain. Now, these abilities include the knowledge among the children, the understanding level among the children, the ability to apply different concepts in different situations, that is also a part of our cognitive aspect of our personality. Then there is analytical abilities among the students. Then there are evaluating abilities or synthesis abilities among the students, and then creative abilities among the students. So we, our personality, are that cognitive dimension of our personality is comprised of different abilities, which you can see on the screen, which includes knowledge, understanding, application abilities, analytical abilities, evaluation abilities, and creative abilities. Now, these are the parts of scholastic aspects. Now, when we talk of scholastic aspects means those aspects which are related to the particular subjects in the school. These subjects may be mathematics, may be science, may be social science, maybe languages, now, or social sciences, or any other subjects. But when we talk of these subjects, why these subjects are taught in the school? The main reason for teaching these subjects in the school, that is to develop different abilities among the students. Now, what those abilities are, we have already discussed. These abilities are to develop the knowledge among the students, to develop their understanding abilities regarding different concepts which are covered in mathematics, science, social science, language, or other subjects. So that means different abilities, whether analytical abilities or knowledge abilities or understanding abilities or creative abilities, through these abilities are developed through different subjects which are taught in the class. So in order to assess whether these abilities have been developed among the students or not, for that we conduct evaluation, and that evaluation should be conducted at regular intervals, at frequent intervals, and that's why it is required what a teacher should do in the class. Teach a small part of the unit, evaluate the students, find their learning mistakes, If any errors are there, any difficulties are there, provide them feedback, provide them remediation, provide them corrective measures, then retest whether those learning difficulties have got removed or not, and then move to the next part of that unit, next lesson of that unit. So in this way, the teacher can move, or teacher can improve the learning among the students and provide them feedback at regular intervals. So this sort of evaluation, which is carried out in different subjects at regular intervals by the teachers to improve the learning, that is evaluation in scholastic aspects. And how this evaluation is carried out? Either through oral questioning, or through written questions, or through practical works. So different techniques are there to evaluate whether the students have learned or not. In order to do that, teacher may apply any of the technique. It should be through observation, it should be through small classroom tests, it should be through evaluation after 1 month or evaluation after 3 months, but it should be a regular feature. And the scholastic part, or the part which is related to different subjects of study in the school, that is known as evaluation of scholastic aspect and at regular intervals. So this is a part of comprehensive evaluation. Now, the other part of comprehensiveness is the evaluation of the co-scholastic aspects. Now, co-scholastic aspects, these are related to child's personality. This is also one part of the child's personality which are related to co-scholastic aspect. We organize, as you know, we organize different activities in the school, co-curricular activities or co-academic activities. Other activities, out-of-school activities are organized by the teachers and the school authorities. Now, why these activities are organized in the schools? This is done so that the different aspects of child personality could be groomed to the highest level, could be developed to the maximum extent possible, so that we organize different type of these activities in the school. Now, what these activities, what type of activities are organized in the school? First, as you can see on the screen, we try to provide them ICT training. ICT training means the training in information and communication technology. We try to develop them, among them, the attitude and values. We try to develop among the children the life skills. We try to provide them health and physical education. We try to develop among them the scientific skills through different practicals or through different field-based activities. We try to develop among them different values related to dignity of the labor, dignity of the manual labor for this work education, or SUPW related activities are organized in the schools. Then there is provision of performing and visual arts to develop among them the creative talent in the students. Then literary and creative skills are developed through different cultural activities. Different sports activities are organized for the better physical development of the children. And in order to develop among them organizational and leadership skills, we frame different committees, we constitute different clubs in the schools, so that such type of leadership skills and organizational skills could be developed among the students. So these are the co-scholastic aspects which are related to child's personality. Now, in order to assess, in order to evaluate whether the child is developing in a proper manner in terms of his physical aspect or not, whether appropriate leadership or organizational skills are being developed among the students, or followership skills are developed among the students. In order to evaluate these, we have different techniques. A teacher can adopt those different techniques to evaluate whether these parts of the personality, these co-scholastic aspects, have been developed to the maximum extent possible or not. So that means comprehensiveness means evaluation in all sort of activities which are undertaken in the school. Earlier, what was done before implementation of CCE in the schools? only the evaluation of the students was done in the scholastic aspect. Only the achievement of the students was assessed in different subjects of study. That is, how much a child has got in mathematics, how many marks a child has received in science subjects. So this was earlier the major emphasis of the educational process. But in continuous and comprehensive evaluation, what we try to evaluate is that is a child should not only be evaluated in subjects of study, in theory subjects, but rather he should be evaluated in all the activities, all the parts of different school activities, which include life skills, his development of attitude and values, development of physical aspect of the personality, development of scientific skills or work education skills. So that means comprehensiveness means including both subjects as well as the co-curricular areas, whether how to what extent a student is participating in different cultural programs, to what extent a student is taking part in physical education activities or sports activities, to what extent a student is contributing towards classroom processes, how much he is contributing to the teaching learning process, helping the teacher, helping his peers in the teaching learning process. So these all are the aspects of child's personality, which is known as co-scholastic part of, or the co-scholastic aspects of his personality. So this includes co-scholastic and co-scholastic in a combined manner makes this comprehensiveness. So continuous and comprehensive evaluation means that is the evaluation of the students in all the subjects of study, in all the activities carried out in the school, and that evaluation should be conducted at regular interval, at regular time, at frequent intervals, and there should be a provision of corrective measures as and when the student is not able to grasp a particular content or his performance in one or the other activity is not up to the mark. We should try to involve him in different activity. So this makes continuous and comprehensive evaluation a total process to evaluate holistic personality development of the child. Now, one question arises: a child cannot perform well in all activities. It is said, it is true, every child cannot perform well in all activities. But the thing is, we try to generate the interest, we try to involve him to the maximum extent possible, to the maximum possible to his abilities, to what level he is able to participate in those activities, and a teacher should develop interest among such students to participate or to involve in different activities so that the inner talents could be developed among those students. So the continuous and comprehensive evaluation means the evaluation of the students at regular intervals, during the formation of the content matter, and at frequent intervals, and in different aspects, different spheres of child's personality, so that he can, or his or her personality can grow to the maximum extent possible, and his abilities can be nurtured to the maximum extent possible. So this is CCE, continuous and comprehensive evaluation. So learners, I think you have understood about the continuous feature of evaluation and the comprehensiveness of evaluation process. Now, what we have learned in this lesson, what we have learned in today's discussion, that is, we learned about the aspects of our personality development. As we already discussed, there are four aspects of personality development: intellectual development, physical development, emotional development, and social and moral development. So evaluation should be a process which should be carried out for assessing the holistic personality development of a child. Our main emphasis of evaluation, or the main objective of the evaluation, is for holistic personality development, assessing whether the child has developed in all aspects or any aspect of the personality he is or she is lagging in that. So for that, evaluation should be carried out. Then we learned about the meaning of evaluation and why there is the need of evaluation. Then we discussed about continuity in evaluation. Then we also understood about the comprehensiveness feature of evaluation. And in the last, we learned about the two major features of the CCE, that is evaluation of scholastic aspects and the evaluation of co-scholastic aspects. So learners, I hope that you have understood about different aspects, the importance and the scholastic and co-scholastic aspects of continuous and comprehensive evaluation. Thank you. Have a good day.